Again, welcome to Electrical Machine 1 lecture. Our topic is transformer. And in the previous lecture, we have already discussed the equivalent circuit of transformer. Now, today's topic is voltage regulation. Voltage regulation of transformer. So first of all, what is the voltage regulation? Voltage regulation is expressed in percentage, and it is defined as the change in terminal voltage from no load to full load, which is expressed in percentage. So as soon as the load is connected to the transformer, the secondary voltage get terminal voltage across the terminal voltage across load get decreases, and this decrease in voltage is due to the equivalent resistance and equivalent reactance in the transformer. Say for example, transformer equivalent circuit, which is referred to secondary side. This is equivalent resistance, equivalent reactance. Here we are taking approximate equivalent circuit, means the shunt component exciting current, no load current, it is has been say ignored, because at full load condition the current as the exciting current and core loss component is very small as compared to the full load current. So as it is referred to the secondary side, load side, so resistance R2 and reactance X2. EMF induced in the secondary of transformer is E2, whereas the voltage across load, is V2, and it is a impedance ZL, load impedance, and current flowing in the secondary winding is I2. We are taking the same notation which already covered for in the previous lecture. Okay, so it is a simplified equivalent circuit of transformer. Now here, no doubt, it is the total resistance referred to the secondary side, as already we have considered, is R2 is equal to R2 plus R1 dash, and which is equal to R2 plus R1 into bracket N2 upon N1 bracket square. Similarly, the reactance X2 is equal to X2 plus X1 into bracket N2 upon N1 bracket square. This is the this one is this. Now, what would be the vector diagram under lagging condition? Say first we will take the lagging condition. So here, lagging power factor, is lagging, because whenever voltage regulation is going to consider, we have to consider or we have to mention what is the rated current and rated voltage is there. Second, voltage regulation at which power factor? It is either it is a lagging power factor, either it is a leading power factor, or unity power factor. So it is mentioned. For example, it is written as percentage regulation is 5%. So in addition to 5% voltage regulation, we have to maintain, we have to mention current is 75% or 100%, whatever it may be that value. Power factor is lagging or leading or unity. It has to be mentioned. If it is not mentioned, it is considered that the power factor is unity and load is 100%. So it is a rated load condition. Okay. Now, here we considered some points there. Let voltage is a reference value. So V2 is equal to V2 at an angle of zero, and current is lagging. I2 is equal to I2 at an angle of minus theta. So the power factor angle is theta, or theta 2, say it is referred to the secondary side, so we will reuse as a theta 2. So here the current is written as, it may be written as I2 cos of theta 2 minus J I2 sine theta 2. Okay. And resistance and reactance R2 and reactance is X2. Now, first of all, we develop the vector diagram. So here, voltage is a reference one. So let the voltage is a reference. Voltage and current is lagging at an angle of theta 2. This is the current lagging at theta 2. Now, the resistance R2 in phase with the current. So, the resistance R2, it is in phase with the current I2 X2. And reactance drop, it is in quadrature with the current. Okay. So, and this total is the EMF induced. This is the voltage. Now, first we will give the nomenclature up to this one, so it become easy to understand. Okay, so here this is a voltage V2. Okay, this voltage is V2. Current is I2, which is lagging at an angle of with respect to voltage is theta 2. This component in phase with the current, it's I2 R2 resistive drop. Similarly, this is I2 X2 reactance drop, and the addition is E2. It is the E2. This voltage is E2. So our what is equation become? It is a E2. This is we are going to apply the Kirchhoff voltage law. So E2 is equal to V2 plus I2 into bracket R2 plus JX2. It is quite simple. Okay. Now voltage E2 is equal to, this is total voltage E2. It is equal to the voltage across load V2 plus resistive drop plus reactance drop. It is in quadrature or 90 degree with respect to the current. Okay. Now this is the vector diagram under lagging power factor. Okay. Now, then under such condition, we can find the voltage E2. Our objective is to calculate EMF induced in the secondary of transformer. See here, the terminal voltage we can measure with the help of voltmeter. Okay. But we cannot measure voltage across secondary winding with the help of voltmeter, because it is not possible, because whatever the winding resistance and reactance it is get dropped in the winding itself. Therefore, it is necessary to calculate the voltage drop across resistance and reactance, and by the formula and by the Kirchhoff voltage law and this equation, it is possible to determine voltage induced in the transformer is E2. Now the difference in voltage, E2 and V2, which is expressed in percentage, is called as a voltage regulation. Okay. So now our equation is E2 is equal to voltage V2 plus I2 into bracket R2 plus JX2. Now put these values. So E2 right here, E2 is equal to V2 plus J0 because it is at a reference one plus I2 cos theta 2 minus J sine I2 sine theta 2 one bracket into impedance, that is resistance R2 plus J X2. Okay. Now, if you just elaborate this one and collecting the imaginary term and real term, voltage E2 is equal to V2 plus I2 R2 cos theta 2 plus I2 X2 sine theta 2, it is in one bracket, plus imaginary term J into bracket I2 X2 cos theta 2 minus I2 R2 sine theta 2. This is the, so this is the equation. From this, our directly on the calculator, it is possible to determine the magnitude of EMF E2 as well as the angle. So that angle is the angle between this voltage V2 and E2. Okay. Or we can say that it is E2 is equal to, we can calculate the magnitude as under root V2 plus I2 R2 cos theta 2 bracket square plus I2 X2 sin theta 2, sorry, this bracket square will not be there. Plus I2 X2 sin theta 2 bracket square plus I2 X2 cos theta 2 minus I2 R2 sin theta 2 bracket square. So by this way, now here it is possible to calculate the EMF induced. Therefore percentage voltage regulation, percentage voltage regulation is equal to E2, the magnitude of voltage E2 minus V2 terminal voltage divided by V2 into 100. Somewhere it is E2 minus V2 divided by E2. It is okay. There is no difference is there in the case. Okay. So we can calculate the voltage regulation by this method. Now, further, it can be say in the vector diagram, we can simplify here. We can do with the help of trigonometric formulas. We can do this trigonometric formulas. Like this is the some, we have to extend the part. Okay, select this is O, give the name O, and this is A, this is B, this is say C, D, and F and G. So this is angle is theta 2. This angle is theta 2 because current and resistive drop both are in phase. So this is theta 2. Now this is I2 R2 and this is angle theta 2. So this part right here, it is I2 R2 cos theta 2. Okay. Whereas F to G, this part, it is I2 R2 sine theta 2. Okay. Now, this part can be written as, because it is a 90 degree, so this angle will be 90 minus, and this is also 90 degree. Okay, so this is 90 degree up to this one. So this angle is 90 minus theta 2. Okay, so here it is I2 R2 cos theta 2. Okay, it is will be sine theta 2, so it become a cos theta 2. Okay, similarly it is a say I2 x2 what is that, cos of 90 minus theta 2. So it can be written as I2 x2 sine theta 2. Similarly, the total one, it is a I2, right here, it is total one, it is a I2 x2 sine 90 minus theta 2. So it can be written as I2 x2 cos of theta 2. From this right angle triangle, that is a right angle triangle, from this is OFC, one can write as OC is equal to OF, O to F square plus FC square. Okay. Now, this OF, that is OF is equal to OA plus OD plus DF bracket square plus into bracket F to C, this part, FC, it is GC minus FG, GF, okay, bracket square. Now put this value O to F, it is V2. O to D is nothing but I2 R2 cos theta 2, here which we have written I2 R2 cos theta 2 plus I2 x2 sine theta 2 bracket square. Where is I2 x2 sine theta 2? This is the part DF, it is equal to BG. Okay, so BG is equal to, what is that? BG is equal to I2 x2 sine theta 2. Okay, this is I2 x2 sine theta 2. Okay, now plus enter bracket G to F, total G to F, it is I2 x2 cos of theta 2 minus this part, it is I2 R2 sine theta 2 bracket. So OF is nothing but E2 square. Therefore, E2 is equal to under root all this term. It is a V2 plus I2 R2 cos of theta 2 bracket plus I2 X2 sine theta 2 bracket square plus I2 X2 cos theta 2 minus I2 R2 sine theta 2 bracket square. So this equation and previous equation is quite same. So either by trigonometric relation or either by say complex number, which it is earlier, it is a good, because all electrical engineering formulas and calculation for the power system, it is based on complex number. So it is advisable to do the calculation by complex number method. Okay, so here the voltage regulation can be determined under lagging power factor. Now let the power factor is unity. What happened? At unity power factor, cos of theta 2 is become 1, sine theta 2 is become 0, because at sine 90, sine 0 is equal to 0 and cos 0 is equal to 1. So at unity power factor, the equation at unity power factor, E2 is equal to, it is V2 plus I2R2, okay, cos theta 2 is equal to 1 at unity power factor, cos of theta 2 is equal to 1 and sine theta 2 is equal to 0. So this term becomes 0, so bracket square. Okay, no doubt it is under square, or you can write as a, okay, under square. Plus, here I2 X2 cos of theta 2 and I2 X2 sine theta 2 term becomes 0. So this is the value. And at unity, at lagging power factor, at leading power factor, what is the change? The change is that here, I write with the different color E2 at unity power factor. Okay, E2 is equal to V2 plus I2 R2 cos theta 2 minus I2 X2 sine theta 2 bracket square. Okay, instead of this one, bracket square plus I2 X2 cos theta 2, instead of minus, here it is a plus I2 R2 sine theta 2 bracket square. So it means that it is a plus or minus. This equation is plus or minus, and here it is plus or minus. So only by changing this to sign, one make a here the leading power factor voltage can be determined. But under voltage, when the power factor is at leading power factor, it is found that the voltage V2 is greater than E2. So therefore, the percentage voltage regulation is minus small v. Okay, so the voltage regulation is negative small. Say so under such condition, the voltage regulation is somewhat positive large . Okay, we will make some. Here is the voltage regulation. That here is the unity power factor. Lagging power factor. And here is the leading power factor. So here it is a positive small. Power factor, voltage regulation is positive small. Here positive large. Power factor value, voltage regulation is large at lagging power factor. No doubt at same voltage, same load current. And here it is negative small. So if the voltage regulation is in the numerical value is negative, it means that it is a leading power factor. Or somewhere, if you are doing some calculation and power factor is given leading, it means that the regulation is negative small. Sometime it is positive, but the voltage regulation is very small. Since under leading power factor, the terminal voltage gap increases. Okay. Now, this is the voltage regulation of a two-winding transformer. We can modify this voltage regulation equation at a smaller term by doing some approximate value. So therefore, approximate voltage regulation . So is in calculation, sometimes it is asked only to calculate the voltage regulation. There is no need to do the detailed calculations are there. So our equation, previous equation is E2 is equal to V2 plus I2 R2 cos theta 2 plus it has lagging power factor, no doubt, I2 X2 sin theta 2. So voltage regulation at lagging power factor. Lagging power factor. This is in one bracket. Okay. Now the second bracket. Second bracket is I2 X2 cos theta 2 minus I2 R2 cos theta 2. Sorry, somewhere it is sin theta 2. Sin theta 2. Like this. Now look at this equation carefully. We found that the first term, this first term equation, first term, this first term comprises of secondary voltage. Let the transformer is say it is the two winding transformer is that it is a 230 volt divided by 115 volt. Okay, means the primary voltage V1, it is 230 volt, and secondary voltage is V2 is equal to 115 volt. So 115 volt is V2. This is the resistance drop which is get added. Reactance drop, again it is added into the V2. Whereas the second term, this second term, it is the difference of these two values. This is the voltage drop across reactance, voltage drop across resistance, and the difference of these two values. So the second component is very small. This component is very small as compared to the first term. So can we neglect? So therefore, we neglect the term as I2 X2 cos theta 2. We said that I2 X2 cos theta 2 minus I2 R2 sine theta 2 is nearly equal to 0, as or it is a negligible is small. Now, what is the equation remains? The equations remains as E2 square, and this is square get cancelled. So we write only the E2 V2 plus I2 R2 cos theta 2 plus I2 X2 sine theta 2. This is the equation, voltage equation, voltage of the secondary EMF induced in the secondary winding of transformer. And this is the terminal voltage plus voltage drop. Now E2 minus V2 is equal to this term get here. So here it is R, I2 R2 cos theta 2 plus I2 X2 sine theta 2 is the differences voltage. Now divide by V2. So equation become, this equation become E2 minus V2 divided by V2 equals to I2 R2 cos theta 2 plus I2 X2 sin theta 2 divided by V2. So now it is a percentage equation. Just if you multiply by 100, so it is a percentage voltage equation. So here we can say that approximate percentage voltage regulation in general, it is equals to I2 R2 cos theta 2 plus or minus I2 X2 sin theta 2 divided by V. So here just it is a positive sign. and negative. So positive sign for lagging power factor and negative sign for leading power factor. Whereas for the unity power factor, sine theta 2 becomes 0. So it is I2 R2 cos theta 2 divided by V2 is the simply it is approximate voltage regulation. Now here one may write as the voltage regulation equation as it is referred to the secondary side. The same calculation can be done, same calculation can be carried out with the help of referred to the primary side. So it is I1, R1. So referred to the resistance, total equivalent resistance referred to the primary side. So current also be the primary side. I1, R1, cos theta 1 plus or minus I1, X1, sin theta 1 divided by V. So the same, all this calculation which here discussed that it can be replaced by the I1 R1 cos theta 1, I1 R I1 X1 sin theta 1, and the voltage instead of V2 it is E1. So by this way, the voltage regulation can be found, approximate voltage regulation can be found, referred to the primary side or referred to the secondary side. Sometimes the voltage regulation is the drops are calculated in term of percentage, in term of per unit value. That is, what is the per unit value? You can write as it is the, we can write as IF1 or I2 R2, I2 R2 divided by V2 cos of theta 2 plus or minus I2 X2 divided by V2 into sin theta 2. There is no change in this equation, only the term get replaced, this one it is get bifurcated, dividing each term, and this term is nothing but the per unit resistance and it is a per unit reactance. So the percentage approximate voltage regulation, it is written as resistance per unit cos theta 2, okay, plus or minus reactance per unit sine theta. So if the resistance and reactance is given in per unit value, so the per unit value is given, again it is possible to calculate the voltage regulation. So today's highlights of our lecture is that voltage regulation is the percentage change in terminal voltage, which is expressed in percentage, is called as a percentage voltage regulation. When one is going to express or specify the voltage regulation, it is necessary to express the load on the transformer. That is, the transformer is a 50% load, 75% load, and 100% load. Second is necessary to mention what is the power factor of load. So if the power factor and the percentage is not given, it is assumed that the voltage regulation has been calculated at full load and unity power factor. This is the meaning. Now the voltage regulation values depend upon the power factor. So at unity power factor, the voltage regulation is positive small. So it will give the better voltage regulation at unity power factor. Whereas lagging and leading, the power factor value may be the percentage voltage regulation is increases in the lagging power factor, and in leading power factor it is negative small because the secondary voltage is slightly greater or it may be equal. So sometimes the leading power factor, the voltage regulation is positive, but it is a small value, that is less than the unity power factor. Now the power factor, now the voltage regulation is detailed voltage regulation can be calculated and approximate voltage regulation can be calculated on required power factor. And the next point is that the voltage regulation can be determined referred to the secondary winding and referred to the primary winding. The magnitude will remain same. The answer will remains same, and also it is expressed in the per unit value. If the per unit resistance of winding is given, again, okay, it can be calculated with the help of this formula. So now today we will stop here. In the next time, we will do some numerical value based on voltage regulation.